Hi, welcome to another segment of Something Artsy. I'm Brenda Nielsen from State Street Theater. I'm an actor, I'm a former board member of State Street Theater, and I've been a participant of the arts for a long time. Something Artsy is brought to you by State Street Theater with the support from the Prairie Lakes Arts Council. This portion of Something Artsy is being filmed at NUCAT in New Ulm. Well, the COVID pandemic has put a little bit of a damper on some of the ways that we do art in our community, but it's also challenged us to think of new ways that, and creative ways that we can experience the arts. This segment of Something Artsy features many of the artistic talents and venues thriving everywhere in our community. So, you just sit back and enjoy seeing how the arts are happening. And thank you for watching this edition of Something Artsy.
Something Artsy, it's good to see you again. This is Lira from the New Ulm Public Library. Hope everyone's hanging in there and doing all right with all the adjustments we're all having to make. The library has had a lot of things going on. We're doing our best despite the restrictions that we're under. And so here's what's going on at the library. First, our summer reading program is getting ready to wrap up here. So if you haven't had the chance, get in there and read. Everybody has the opportunity to participate, and there's great prizes for the kids and some neat things coming up for the teens as well. We also have been having our memory lab is now up and running, so you can make appointments either by calling us on the phone, stopping in at the desk, or you can also use our website, www.newulmlibrary.org, and click on the tree, the memory lab tree, and that will take you to our reservation page there. We still have contactless curbside pickup, so if you're not ready to come to the library, not feeling well, and so forth, you're welcome to give us a call and set up an appointment, and we'll get your books ready and get them checked out on your card and set them out on the cart for you to pick up out by the door by the book drop. Speaking of, the book drop is open Monday and Thursday from 8:30 in the morning until 5:30 in the evening, and so make use of that if you're able to, but when you come to the library, please utilize the black bin just through the main doors. That will give you the location for placing your books. Don't bring them to the circulation desk. And of course, with the governor's mandate, please wear a mask when you come in. If you happen to forget, we do have some masks on hand that we can give to you for use, but please remember to bring your own. We're keeping the library clean as we can. No seating in the library at the moment. You can come in and use our public computers. We do still have printing and copying and scanning services available, so use those as well. We're also continuing our virtual programming. We've been having our adult book discussions in virtual format every other week through the summer. We've done a couple for the Mystery Book Club, and we've got our first History Book Club one coming up in a couple weeks. So keep your eyes peeled for those on our events page on the library website there. And we also, and this is something we're excited about, normally we don't do too much children's programming in August because it's right after summer reading, but since we haven't been able to do a lot of the things that we had planned, we are going to be doing our first ever virtual cake decorating competition with this time the theme is cupcakes, and the model cupcakes, I should say, are being provided by New Ulm's very own Sweet Mabel's Cupcakes, which are featured at the Minnesota Ice ice cream shop downtown. And we are going to be having three judges from local restaurants and bakeries. It'll be a lot of fun. The registration link is there on, again, on the library events page. So click on that and get connected. We also still have our story walk up in Nell's Park. So head on over there with the kids and take them around. And we hope that you all are staying safe and healthy. And we'll see you at the library.
Hi, my name is Jack Fairbairn. I'm 20 years old and go by the rap name Flow Fanatic. I've been making music probably since I was about 13. It all started off, you know, I heard Notorious B.I.G.'s Juicy, and his lyrics just got stuck in my head, and it was the first song that I ever memorized. And ever since then, I knew that rap was something that I always wanted to do. So I got deeper into it, finding more names like Slick Rick, Nas, Tupac, Snoop Dogg, the Wu-Tang Clan, Dr. Dre, Eminem, Jay-Z, so on. Lots of names, Eric B. and Rakim. And it just really made me want to do it. And I just love the culture of the music and how, you know, music can really, you know, uplift in a mood. When I was younger, if I was feeling down, I would listen to a song and it would just get me in a good mindset and I would actually fully listen to the lyrics. So with that being said, coming with my art form with rap music, I would definitely say I'm more so of a lyricist, meaning that I like my lyrics to be well understood by people that are viewing my music and can understand what I can say, and also have a beat in the background that can correlate with it to help raise the emotion so people can just fully understand the whole meaning and context of the song that I'm making. I was blessed to get the opportunity from Ian Kimmel, who nominated me for this video. And I am glad that State Street Theater Company is doing something like this, helping out local artists and getting their names out there for all the people that, you know, have dreams and visions and want to do, you know, this for the rest of their life. So I appreciate that opportunity. I probably would say that I write lyrics every single day and I freestyle 2 to 4 hours a day. I always try to add another 5 minutes at the ending of all my sessions just to keep prolonging it until I can get the 10,000 hours in, which is a scientific fact that if you put those 10,000 hours in, it's proven that you will do tremendous things and your determination will only be to succeed. And that's exactly what I'm working for. I am currently a junior at Minnesota State University Mankato. I am majoring in music business and music songwriting and also minoring in business. Reason why I'm taking those classes is for the songwriting part. It can help me out with obviously increasing my talent and, you know, putting it forth into my music. And then with the business part, it helps me with the industry side with potential labels if that opportunity comes, and, you know, not being clueless if they're trying to rip me off and I just won't know what to do and I can just sign a paper and boom, they own me. So the music business aspect is a really big one, and also the business aspect as my minor is also a very big one to have, and it will help me out in the future. I played sports my whole life in New Ulm. I played hockey and baseball, loved it, met a lot of great friends, still friends with them today. I knew that sports probably wasn't going to be my strong suit coming out. I knew that I would probably have to figure out something else, you know, with a college degree if I wanted to do sports management or be a sports agent. So I did that my first year, freshman year. I took a couple classes and I really liked them. But I also took some music industry classes and some musicianship classes and learned a little bit how to play piano and other stuff and really get in depth with beats and break them down by each single instrument and how it sounds. And I knew in that moment that music was what I wanted to do the rest of my life. So I am happy to get this opportunity from the State Street Theater Company for putting my name out there. And like I said, my name is Jack Fairbairn. I'm 20 years old and I go by the rap name Flow Fanatic. I'm gonna rap a little bit of acapella so you can see kind of a glimpse of what I do. And thank you.
Speaking for human beings, you in it are inconsistent. You need the grind on the clock of the sofa is where you're living. No flopping for television with 7 trips in the kitchen. I'm working the overnight, keeping steady with my persistence. Houston, I'm on a mission. My rocket's filled with ignition. Igniting my destiny to a famous label musician. Hungry for making music, it's building my life ambition. My talent from off the dome is the same, even if it's written. See, I don't know what I should do. I get my vision and opinions can come, but you just gotta fight the critics. Magazines will maybe push you in them, but it's just the congratulations when you finally get it.
Hi, my name is Benji Iniger. I'm the executive director of Pro Musica Minnesota. And I just wanted to tell you about something cool and interesting that's happening with our organization right now. So for the past 4 seasons, Summit Avenue Music Series has been producing concerts at Chapel of the Christ at Martin Luther College. And for the past 2 years, we've been producing concerts here at Bethany Lutheran College in Trinity Chapel as part of our Pro Musica Summer Chamber Music Festival. What's going on is that we've decided to combine the two organizations. It's shared leadership, it's shared a lot of resources, and so now this allows us to be more flexible and more efficient with our resources, and we've combined those and have applied to be a nonprofit organization. And so we're going through that process right now. It's going very well, and we're very excited that we can use this opportunity to bring you more chamber music offerings in the area. And so we'll have more information on our website, promusicamn.com, and you can also follow us on social media on Twitter and Facebook, and we'll have more information for you there. But thank you for coming and seeing our concerts, and we look forward to having you part of our growth process. It's going to be very fun and exciting, so looking forward to seeing you there.
I'm Bethel Balgi, and I'm the Artistic Director of Summit Avenue Music Series and Pro Musica Minnesota, and I'm delighted to tell you all about our upcoming season. So the season's title is Table for Three. We have 3 concerts, we have 3 performers in each concert, and the title of the first concert is the 3 B's. The program will include pieces by Bach, Beethoven, and Brahms. So I'd like to describe briefly what these concerts are going to be about, with a caveat that the dates that I'm going to tell you are subject to change based on the COVID situation. So at the moment, we had planned to have a concert September 20th. That has been postponed to January 17th. And this program includes the fabulous principal clarinetist from the Minnesota Orchestra, Gabriel Campos Zamora, and the cellist Silver Ayinome. And we are, instead of having a concert on the 20th, we are going to, a live performance, I should say, we're going to have a virtual concert that will show. So watch for information about this virtual concert on September 20th. But we're hoping still for a live concert then on January 17th. The next concert will be April 11th, and this will be Perry Karp, a fabulous cellist from the Pro Arte Quartet, and soprano Catherine Worcester. And the program title is Cello Treasures. The season finale is scheduled for May 2nd, and this will be called Pale Yellow. And you'll see familiar faces. This is Peter McGuire and Richard Belcher and myself. So I look forward to seeing you. Watch for all information, any updates on our website. It's a new website, promusicamn.com. See you soon. Thank you.
Hi, it's Brenda Nielsen again, and I'm here to give you a little information about what's going on at State Street Theater. Now, this segment is being filmed about the middle of August, and State Street has just finished its first venue within the theater itself. We just performed a radio production of Sherlock Holmes last weekend. It was a fun hour and a half production and gave us the opportunity to practice some of our preparedness planning and get our feet back on the ground at State Street Theater. So now coming up, there's a lot of things that are going on. One of them is the virtual happy hours segment on Facebook. Now this idea came from one of our board members and our executive director who solicited restaurants in New Ulm to come up with several drink ideas representing some of the State Street Theater plays and musicals that have been done in the past. There are drinks concoctions like Emerald Isle from The Wizard of Oz, or Sangria from Drinking Habits. You remember that show? It was a bunch of nuns who were making wine in the convent. Well, the first event is scheduled for this Friday, August 14th at 7 p.m. on Facebook. Each event will be seen on Facebook, and there are State Street actors and restaurant employees creating the signature drinks that will be featured at each event. Recipes for the drinks will be available, as well as the ability to donate to State Street Theater at each virtual event. We want to thank the following restaurants for participating in creating and filming these events. They are Social, Lola's, Applebee's, and Lamplighter. We are grateful for their help and encourage our viewers to support these businesses. The next thing that's going on is auditions for the children's classic, Charlotte's Web. Staging for the show will look a little different than you've seen some of the Charlotte Web's productions in the past. We have to think about distancing, but don't worry. Wilbur, Templeton, Fern and her family, the animals, and of course Charlotte will all be there. The play is being directed by Wendy Tuttle, and it's being produced by yours truly. Auditions will be at the theater in the following dates: September 14th from 6:30 to 8 p.m., September 17th from 6:30 to 8 p.m., and then on Saturday morning from 9:30 to 11 a.m. We're looking for actors 16 and older to play the roles. The performance of Charlotte's Web will be November 20th, 21st, and 22nd. Tickets will be on sale soon online and at Hy-Vee. And finally, the film Rocky Horror Show will be returning to the theater on October 31st at 8:30 p.m. Some of your favorite shadow actors will be there to entertain you, and they will all be returning, and they're very excited to be returning to the event. Tickets will be available online and at Hy-Vee. And as always, you can contact us at State Street Theater via our website, which is statestreettheater@gmail.com, or our phone number is 507-359-9990. Or of course, you can get to us on Facebook. Thanks for joining us on this segment of what's happening at State Street Theater.